Om Shanti. I relate to the word divinity so much because at my early childhood, I always felt within me divinity and also connection with divine. And I always used to say that my roots are in divine. But when I understood that yes, I as a soul, I was worshipworthy, I was divine. And then how gradually I lost that divinity and acquired different kinds of values. And so when that realization came, then again the journey to become divine. I also understood that how my ascending in purity, in divinity, is beneficial to the whole world. So generally, you know, we look around and we say, look at the condition of people, or sometimes people have different kinds of attitude. But I always feel being guided by inner divinity. And I maintain it because I knew that I have to play this part. Before coming to knowledge, I was a devotee of Lord Krishna and all other goddesses, gods. Pray regularly, worship regularly. But then I knew that I have to pay attention to inculcate divine virtues. But everything begins with the purity. When there is purity within your own self, you feel that you are divine, divinity. And then, of course, some of the qualities of that unlimited, generous heart, using, seeing everyone, the third eye of knowledge as a soul. And contentment, free from all desires. But one of the special expression of that divinity is giver or bestower. Before Jnana, I used to just feel like serving as a volunteer, keep giving, sharing. And now I realize that that whole desire only to serve was coming from the divine and pure self. And now realizing that before the giving was more on a physical level, but now this giving and the sharing is for the souls. Share whatever anyone requires. Maybe someone doesn't understand full knowledge, but we can just share what is the need of that soul. If soul is it in the need of peace or love, and then if yes, that's what you have to share. Share the words of wisdom, words of blessings. And just having good wishes and pure feelings is like giving love and light and some spiritual strength. So bestowing is one of the most important quality of divinity. Because unlimited generous heart is the expression also of divinity. And you always hold the good qualities of everyone. Because holding always that pure vision towards others also is a great bestowing, and it helps. Maybe that soul is not able to see one's own qualities, but by you looking at those specialties, make souls aware of their good qualities. And that's what actually Baba does to us. We didn't know our qualities. Baba's drishti on us, on our specialties and qualities, immediately helped us. And I knew that who am I? And I was worship worthy, divine. I have become worshipper, I have to again become worship worthy. That thought was created in us by God. It's not my ambition or thought. I could never think that way. But now I know that God has come to make us worship worthy. So through purity, divinity and divine virtues, I think, is our main focus in life. And definitely because of that, there is a lot of inner joy, there is bliss and contentment. So our journey at present is to become worship worthy and become source of strength and light for all the souls of the world. We have memorials of those who are worship worthy, but now we are those souls. So we have to keep ascending, think of bringing benefit to the whole world, always have good wishes, pure feelings for everyone. And I always deep within see a little image of that worship-worthy soul. I really see it as a goddess, one who constantly bestows, constantly shares. So I'm sure that all of you will also reflect on this and feel it and stay in that awareness. And through your drishti, just fulfill everyone's desire to experience divinity, to experience peace, to experience love. We have received from Baba and we have to share now with everyone. Om Shanti.